What's the best video editing software on Windows right now? And which one is the best one for you, for your budget, and for your level of experience? Here's our roundup of the current editing software landscape and my recommendations on the best ones for you. Hey, it's Justin Brown here from Primal Video. We release a ton of content to help you get better results with your videos faster. If you're new here, then make sure you click that big subscribe button, and all the links to everything we mentioned in this video, you can find linked in the description box below. So let's jump into it. Choosing the right video editing software can be incredibly confusing no matter what level you're at. The number of options seems to only be increasing, which is great for competition and prices and driving new features, but not so great if you're trying to weigh up your options and trying to figure out which one is right for you. So we do a video like this every 6 to 12 months for both PC and for Mac with an overview of the current landscape and our recommendations for best editing software across multiple budgets, so from free to $200 plus software. As always, there've been some big changes since our last video. Some of my prior recommendations will still make the cut, whereas others have fallen behind and newer options have stepped in to take their place. Now, just like last time, I'm gonna break this overview down into multiple pricing categories so that you can see what's available at each level. You can hear our recommendations, and if you're starting out in one of the lower pricing brackets, then you can know what you're missing out on or that you could upgrade to later. And while you're watching, make sure you let us know what video editing software you're using right now and what your favorite feature is down in the comments. It's always interesting to hear the experience that others are having with their software, and your suggestions may help others make the call on which software is right for them. And once we wrap up looking at all the editing software, I'm also gonna share my top three tips for editing faster, no matter what software you're using. Okay, so now onto the software. We've broken this down into three categories. We're gonna start off looking at free software, then we're gonna look at sub $200, and then $200 plus. So let's get started. So first up, free software. Now, these options are really going ahead in leaps and bounds, and some of the software that's available these days for free totally beats out a lot of the paid options available just a few years ago. So in this pricing bracket, you've got software like AVS Video Editor, VSDC has a free version, WeVideo has a free version, HitFilm Express, Shotcut, Lightworks, Avid Media Composer First, and DaVinci Resolve. Now, this is the first time that we've included VSDC free and Avid Media Composer First as well. And in the last one, we had Windows Movie Maker, which is still seems to be an obvious choice for people when they're looking for Windows video editing software, but it's now no longer officially supported. So you actually can't download it anymore. So that's why it's not on our list. Now, after testing all of these, my top two picks are VSDC and DaVinci Resolve. Now, for someone who's just starting out with video editing, I really like that VSDC is really easy to use. It's pretty intuitive. It runs really, really well, and you don't need to have the latest and greatest system to be able to run everything in it. But if you do have a decent system, then it's gonna take use of that hardware and accelerate everything for you. So for someone that's an absolute beginner up to maybe intermediate, or someone that's not looking for all the additional bells and whistles and isn't looking to do any professional projects, just wants to edit basic videos or YouTube videos, then this will be perfect for you. Now, DaVinci Resolve is something that's really a no-brainer. It is more complicated to use. It is actually professional video editing software that they use to cut feature films and color grade feature films. So it is an awesome feature set that you're getting for nothing. So it is definitely worth using and worth learning if you're looking to create more advanced videos, or if you're just starting out and you're looking for the best free piece of software to learn that is scalable, because you can move up to the paid version as well, then I would recommend DaVinci Resolve. The feature set is just insane. The performance that you'll get editing both consumer grade and professional video files is just insane. Now, I've had to pick a winner for best overall free video editing software on Windows. It's gonna go to DaVinci Resolve. Really, there is nothing better in the free category for video editing software, but it could probably be a bit too advanced for someone that is an absolute beginner for video editing, and for them, I'd recommend VSDC. Now, with the free version of DaVinci Resolve, there really aren't too many limitations. Obviously, there is a paid version as well, which we will cover a bit later on, but you're not really missing out on too much in the free version, which is what makes this so amazing. So the next category we're gonna look at is the sub $200 category. So in here, what you'll normally find with these pieces of software is that they are not cut down pieces of software. Normally these are a full end-to-end editing solution, meaning that you won't have to pay any additional fees to remove things like watermarks or to pay for additional features. So typically everything in here, as I said, will work as a full end-to-end solution. So the reason that we picked $200 as the cutoff and sub $200 for this category is because there's a lot of software that sits around that $150 to $199 price point. And above that, there's actually a pretty decent gap between the $200 and some of the other more professional options. So that's why we've picked $200. So let's jump in and see what editing software is in this category. So in here, you've got software like VSDC Pro, so the paid version. You've got Filmora, WeVideo, now that's the paid version of it, the watermark free version, Magix Movie Edit Pro Premium, Adobe Premiere Elements, CyberLink Power Director, Camtasia, and Lightworks Pro. So all of these pieces of software, whether they're subscription based or not, will not cost you more than $200 for the year or $200 outright to purchase this software. Now moving into this price bracket, the free options still apply. And one of them that stacks up is DaVinci Resolve. It's super powerful, as we've just covered off when we spoke about it in the free software for professional video editing and for someone looking for the most advanced piece of video editing software that is free. But now we'll be looking at the other options here as well that weren't available in the free space. My top three picks are Adobe Premiere Elements, CyberLink Power Director, and WeVideo. Now, while Filmora and VSDC Pro aren't in my top three picks here, if you try my top three picks and you aren't a big fan, then I would recommend to check out those next because they are still a solid solution for editing videos. They are rather powerful as well. So WeVideo is a subscription-based online cloud-based editing solution, meaning that it all runs in your web browser. There's no software to download and install. It's amazing for collaborative video editing, where you can upload your files and have people from anywhere in the world working with you, helping you edit your projects down. It also means that you can edit your videos on systems that don't need to be powerful at all, because all the processing is done on the cloud. So as I said, it is subscription-based, meaning that you'll be paying per month to be able to access and to be able to use the application, but it only comes in at around $5 per month if you want to export up to 720p video files. And if you want the top plan at around $8, that'll give you access to 4K and 1080p exports as well. So amazing. I really like that Adobe Premiere Elements is essentially just a cut down version of the professional Adobe Premiere Pro, which makes it a great option for someone that's starting out video editing and wanting to come into the game at that $99 price point for Premiere Elements with the option in mind or with the goal in mind to upgrade later to Adobe Premiere Pro if that's what you're after. You don't have to, it will still do everything that you want. There's a great range of file types and compatibility. The performance is all there. It is a solid editing solution, but having that logical step up or logical progression to the professional version is a great thing to have if you're looking to advance your video editing. And I really like CyberLink Power Director, how it's not just video editing. It's also got a built-in screen recorder that works really, really well. It ties directly into your GPU, so it's really powerful and your render times are really fast. It's got things like 360 video editing built in. So at that $65 price point for CyberLink Power Director, I think it is a really solid solution for video editing on Windows. So if I had to pick a winner out of these three, WeVideo, Adobe Premiere Elements, and CyberLink Power Director for the sub $200 category, I would pick Adobe Premiere Elements. That would be my recommendation because it has that logical step up to Adobe Premiere Pro. If you learn one, you can easily move to the other, which is really, really powerful. Now, obviously with all video editing software, it's really important to keep in mind that they are just tools to get the job done. As I've said, there's fors and against for all of these pieces of video editing software, and what works best for you might be totally different to someone else. So wherever possible, download the trial versions, give as many as you can a go and see which one works best for you, for your workflow, and for the type of videos you're creating, because they are essentially just tools to edit video, tools to get the job done. So if you take that approach when you're looking at videos, look for the best tool for you. Obviously then, if you're looking for a cloud-based editing solution, then the no-brainer answer there is WeVideo. Or if you're really interested in doing 360 videos and doing them well, then PowerDirector may be the option for you. But overall, my recommendation in this category is Adobe Premiere Elements. Okay, so now onto the final category, which is $200 plus. So in this category, we're really looking at all the professional grade editing packages. So the biggest things that you'll usually find with these pieces of editing software is you'll have more control over your edit. So you'll have a much more advanced feature set. You'll have much more advanced tools in regards to color correction. You'll usually have a much larger range of file types or codecs that you can use in your projects. These software applications will be much more robust and solid for longer form projects like documentaries. They're going to not crash as much and be much more friendly to working with multiple editors or a team to help you create your videos. So this is really where you're gonna get all the advanced bells and whistles, things like stabilizers built in, better text effects, better animations, better graphics integrations. This is all the professional software. Now it's important to note with these, once again, that some of these are subscription based. Like you've got Avid Media Composer, which is around $50 per month, and you've got Adobe Premiere Pro, which is around $20 per month, and the others are paid. So HitFilm Pro sells for $349, Vegas Pro Edit at $399, and DaVinci Resolve Studio currently selling for $299. Now, after testing all of these, my top two picks here are Adobe Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve Studio. Now with DaVinci Resolve, we've already said it's an amazing piece of software for free. So the biggest differences that you get with the paid version include more GPU effects or effects that are going to utilize your video card for faster rendering and better performance, but also things like true 4K and higher than 4K resolutions that you can edit for your projects. There's also a heap more really advanced color correction tools and features that they've got in there as well. Adobe Premiere Pro is probably the most popular video editing application in this category. It seems to be one that if you mention video editing software on Windows or Mac, that a lot of people would have at least heard of Adobe Premiere Pro. And that's for good reason. It has an amazing feature set. The color correction and color tools in there are really, really good. It is amazing to work with teams as well, to simply share the video projects or use the Adobe Cloud to work with your team remotely. It is a really solid solution for professional video editing, but also for smaller projects as well. There's a lot of people that are starting out their YouTube channels and jumping straight in to Adobe Premiere. Now, picking a winner in this category out of DaVinci Resolve and Adobe Premiere Pro is probably the hardest decision out of all the other ones previous. I have been a longtime Adobe Premiere user after I was an Avid user for many years before that. So I went to Avid to Premiere. Now I'm using Final Cut a lot as well, but I'm really, really impressed with DaVinci Resolve. But I feel that Adobe Premiere Pro is still the more complete package at this point. So my recommendation in this category will go to Adobe Premiere Pro. I really like the integration that you have with the rest of the Adobe suite. A lot of people are turned off by the subscription model that it is $20 a month, but really if you're taking your video editing seriously and you buy the whole package and you get Photoshop and After Effects and everything built in, then it is a solid solution to allow you to do everything, your motion graphics, your video editing, your color, all in one place. So for that, it's really, really powerful, and that's why it's my pick. So I understand that all of that is definitely a lot to take in, but before we wrap up with my top three tips for editing faster in any software, let's do a quick recap. Out of all the free video editing software on Windows, and there is a heap of them, we narrowed it down to two, VSDC and to DaVinci Resolve, with my pick or my recommendation being DaVinci Resolve. And then in the sub $200 category, we narrowed all the options down to WeVideo, Cyberlink Power Director, and Adobe Premiere Elements, with my recommendation going to Adobe Premiere Elements. And then in the $200 plus category, so this is where all the professional video editing software is, we narrowed it down to Adobe Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve Studio, with my pick going to Adobe Premiere Pro. Okay, so my top three tips to help you edit your videos faster. The first one is to be aware that your editing actually starts in your filming. So when you're filming, make sure that you're not filming a heap of extra footage that you know you're not ever going to use or is not ever going to make the cut for your final edit. So be conservative with the footage that you're actually capturing, because then less footage in your editing means that you'll be able to edit faster because you've got less footage to go through. So consider your editing while you're filming, and that alone will help you edit faster because you've got less footage to deal with. Tip number two is when you're filming, once again, make sure that you're only moving on to the next section or next dot point, next paragraph, when you've nailed the last take or when you're happy with the last take. So make your best take the last one. And then in your video editing, instead of working from left to right, edit backwards and edit from right to left. So that way you'll always hit that best take first, and then you can go back through, remove all the mistakes, and then you'll get the next best take. So it makes it a much faster way to edit down a heap of footage to just the best takes or just the content really, really fast. And tip number three is to save all your effects, your color corrections and everything till last. Most people get excited and want to jump straight in and start applying effects and making their footage look good before they've actually gone through the process of editing their footage down. So all this does is put your computer or your iPad or your Android device, whatever you're editing on, under a heap of load and slows down the entire process. So focus on cutting all of that footage down to something small and manageable first, and then you can start making it look good by applying your color corrections and effects. So don't do that stuff until later. Now, these are just three tips from our full video editing process guide called the Primal Video Method. There's a link to where you can watch the video talking through the entire method on screen now, and also a direct link to where you can download the PDF version as well. I'll see you soon.